Okay, so from this given problem, so we have actually a simple beam with two concentrated loads at points B and C, 60 kips at saka 40 kips. Using area moment method, determine the slopes at ends A and D and the deflections at points B and C of the beam shown in the figure. Okay, so in solving deflections, the first step is, of course, we have to solve for the reactions. Okay, so let's say, let us name it as reaction at A, and the other one is reaction at D. Okay, so let's say summation of moment at A equal to zero. So let's say positive is clockwise, so we'll have, okay, so 60 times 20 plus 40 times 30, then minus RD times 40. Okay, so that would be equal to zero. So solving for that RD, we could solve that RD is equal to 60 kips, and that is upward positive. Okay, so let me check. 60 times 20 plus 40 times 30 divided by 40. Okay, so we got 60. Then if we sum up forces or vertical equal to zero, and let's say pataas are positive forces, so we'll have RA, so unknown, plus RD, so we got it as 60, then minus 60 minus 40 equals zero. So from there, we could say that the reaction at A is just equal to 40 kips. And again, that is directed upward. Okay, so we're done with the reactions. Okay, so again, this is 60 and this is 40. Now, the next thing that we have to do is to draw the elastic curve. Okay, so let's say this is the elastic curve. Again, the elastic curve would be the deflected form of the beam after loading. So that's hinge and this is roller. Okay, so let's see what will happen. Okay, so because the loads are vertically downward, so most likely the elastic curve would be a positive moment, naka-smile. Okay, so let's say that is the elastic curve. Okay, so we have to identify points on the elastic curve. Let's say yung point A remains at the same point. The same with point D. So parehas lang ang before and final position ng point A and D. Pero yung point B, after loading, dito siya mapupunta yung point B. Likewise, yung point C, dito siya mapupunta. So ito na ngayon yung bagong position ng points B and C. Okay? So let's start with the slopes at A and D. So let's start with slope at A. Okay, so theta A is being asked. Okay, so theta A, so what I'm going to do is to draw a line. Okay, so I'll draw a line from point A, a tangent line from A. I'll draw a tangent line there. So let's say this is the tangent line at A. Okay, so if that is tangent line at A, meaning to say, the slope at A is this one. So this is theta A. Okay, so to solve for that theta A, we could consider this one from point D to the tangent line at A. That is deviation, right? Deviation of point D when a tangent line is drawn at A. Okay, so meaning to say, I could solve for theta A by knowing the deviation of D slash A. Tapos I have the 40 feet. No? So considering the triangle, we could say that tangent of theta A is equal to opposite. The opposite is the deviation, TD slash A. Then the adjacent is 40 feet. Okay, so from there, I could solve for theta A. Now, the question is, what is deviation of D slash A? So as per theorem number 2, that is equivalent to 1 over EI, okay, of the area of the moment diagram between points A and D. Tapos taken distance from the centroid of point D. Okay? I mean, centroid of the moment diagram taken about point D. So, in short, from this problem, we need to draw the moment diagram. Okay, so let us draw the moment diagram. Okay, first, okay, so let us consider this, say, okay, so let's say this is the moment diagram. Okay, so let's say M over EI diagram. Okay, so in drawing the moment diagram by parts, we have to choose a reference axis. Okay, so let's say I will choose point D to be my reference. Okay, so I will choose this as my reference axis, yung point D. So kung point D ang reference ko, ano yung moment effect ng lahat ng forces about D? Okay, so yun yung ibig sabihin ng moment diagram by parts. Ano yung moment effect ng lahat ng loads dun sa beam with respect to point D? Okay, so as you can see, what are the forces on the beam? We have the RA, diba? We have the RA, we have the 60 kips, we have the 40 kips, tsaka yung RD. Okay, yung RD, wala siyang moment effect kasi nandun siya sa reference point D. Wala siyang moment effect about D. So what are the moments effects? So pagka sa RA, okay, so yung RA, diba pataas siya? So from point A, pataas siya. So I'm going, okay. So from point A, okay. So up to point D. So there you have the moment. So the moment there would be RA 40 times 40 feet. Okay, so 40 kips times 40 feet is 1,600. So again, this is 1,600. Okay. So tiba ang moment diagram ng isang concentrated load is a first degree curve. Diba, if you will recall the shear and moment diagram, diba, due to concentrated load, ang shear diagram niyan, horizontal, uniform, parang rectangle. Tapos rectangle, 0 degree yun. Diba? Pagpunta mo sa moment diagram, magiging first degree. Kaya ito ay naging first degree. Okay, so naging triangle siya. Now, next, how about yung due to 60 kips? Okay, so due to 60 kips, andito yung point of application, pababa siya. So ang moment effect niya with respect to D would be this one. 60 times 20. Okay, so ito yun. Let's say ito yun. So 60 yung load times the moment arm hanggang D, 20. So 60 times 20 is 1,200. Kaya lang pababa siya, kaya negative 1,200. Ayan. Okay, so what else? How about yung due to 40 kips? Okay, so due to 40 kips, so gagawa pa ako dito na isang line para mahiwalay ko yung 40 kips. Okay, so sa 40 kips naman, pababa siya at point C, diba? Okay, pababa siya sa point C. So from there, gagawa ulit ako ng triangular load. So 40 times 10, that is 400. Negative 400. Okay, so 40, the concentrated load, and the distance hanggang sa D is 10. So that's 400. So first degree din yung mga curves nila, diba? First degree lahat yan. Ibig sabihin, triangle lahat yan. Bakit first degree? Kasi these are the moments coming from a concentrated load. No? So, concentrated load, tapos sa shear diagram, magiging uniform, nagiging rectangular 0 degree. So, pagdating sa moment diagram, first degree. Kaya puro triangle ang na-form niya due to concentrated loads. So, as you can see from this moment diagram, I have three triangles. So, yan yung area ng moment diagram ko. Actually, from this case, what I did is nag-reference ako sa point D. Kayo bahala, no? So, pwede kayo mag-reference kahit sa ang points. So, the solution would be the same. I mean, the final answer would be the same. Irregardless kahit saan ka mag-take ng reference ng pagdodrawing ng moment diagram by parts. Okay? Okay, so, isolve na natin ngayon to. Okay, so yung deviation d slash a is 1 over ei. Okay, so this is 1 over ei. Okay, so what is the area of the moment diagram? Okay, so from this kulay green na diagrams, we have three diagrams, di ba? Yung first triangle natin, nandito yung centroid. Yung second triangle natin, nandito yung centroid. Tapos yung third triangle natin na maliit, nandito yung centroid. Okay? So area muna, yung pinakamalaki muna, yung positive na triangle. So the area is 1 half, the base is 40, and the height of the triangle is 1,600. So yan yung area ng triangle. Kaya lang, we need to multiply it with the distance of its centroid measured from D. So take note, sa D ako mag-take ng distance kasi yung deviation sa D yung hinahanap ko. Okay, so the centroid distance of the distance of the centroid here from the D would be 1/3 of, diba? So times 1/3 of 40. So 1/3 of 40. Okay. So yan ngayon yung area times distance para dun sa unang triangle na pinakamalaki. Okay? Now, we're going to consider the next triangle. Yung maliit naman, yung nasa ilalim, yung 1,200. So it would be, so let's say plus, area of the triangle is 1 half. The base of the triangle, yung triangle na green, from B to D is 20. Base, 20. And yung height ng triangle is yung negative 1,200. So negative 1,200. So yan yung area ng triangle. Ang centroid niya is nahandito, diba? So anong distance ng centroid niyan from D? D pa rin. So that is 1/3. 1/3 of 20. So 20 over 3. So yan naman yung para sa second triangle sa baba. Tapos yung pangatlong triangle natin yung pinakamaliit. Okay? So yung negative 400. So plus another triangle. 1 half, the base is 10 lang. Tapos yung height ng triangle natin is negative 40. Okay? So times distance. Anong distance yan? 1/3 of 10. So 1/3 of 10. So yan na lahat yung area ng tatlong green rectangle, green triangles. Okay? So with that, I could solve for the deviation of D slash A. And that is in terms of AI. Okay, so calculator lang natin. 40 times 16 divided by 2 times 40 over 3. Okay. Then 20 over 2 times negative 1, 2. Okay. Times 20 over 3. Okay. Then times 400 times 10 over 3. Okay, so the answer is 340,000. 340,000 1, 2, 3 over EI. Okay, so yan yung deviation. Now, ano yung unit ng deviation? Ano yung unit ng deviation? Diba ang unit ng moment natin, ang unit ng moment natin is force times distance. So that is in kip feet. So ito yung unit ng moment natin, kip foot. So moment. Tapos moment, tas minultiply mo pa siya sa distance. Yung area ng diagram would be kip foot square times yung distance pa. So magiging kip foot cube. Okay, so yan yung unit niya. Okay, so substituting values, that would be 340,000 divided by EI. Okay, E is elasticity, 1,800. The 1,800 kips per square inch. Okay, square inch. Tapos, yung I is 46,000. 46,000 inch to the fourth. Inch to the fourth. So, yung sa taas natin is kip feet cube. Okay, so convert natin yung cubic foot sa inch cube. That is 1 foot is 12 inches, tapos i-cube din natin. Okay, so that would give us answer in square Okay, square inch. So, inch lang. So, matitira dyan, inches lang. Okay, so, times 12 cubed. Okay, so divided by 1/8 divided by 4600. Okay. So we got here 7.0956 etc. This is inches. So yan yung deviation natin in inches. Okay, so let me store lang muna to sa A para hindi mawala sa calculator ko. Okay? So to solve for theta A, so that would be tangent of theta A is equal to the TDA 7.0956, kaya lang inches to, no? Divided by the adjacent is 40 feet. Kaya lang 40 feet, i-convert natin siya sa 12 inches is in 1 foot. Ayan, so para maging consistent. So from there, I could solve for theta A already. Okay? So divided by 40, divided by 12. Okay, so arctangent. So this is 0.84691. So degrees. Oops. Times times pi over 180. Okay, so this is in degrees. So if I want to solve, convert it to radians, so times mo lang ng pi over 180. So para maging radians. So therefore, our theta A is equal to 14.78, okay, times 10 to the negative 3 radians. Okay, so yan ang sagot. So that is the slope at A. Okay? Okay, so that is theta A. Next, so pag-solve ng theta D, ganun din halos yung solution natin. The same what we did dito sa theta A. So next is, ang gawin natin is solve for the deflection naman sa C. Okay, so deflection sa C naman ang isolve natin. Okay, so deflection sa C. Okay, so how do we solve for the deflection sa C? Okay, so let us call it as YC. That is the deflection at C. Okay, so how do we solve for delta C? Okay, so if you look at the elastic curve again, diba ito yung delta C? So ito yung maliit na to. From the original position of point C, dun sa final position ng point C. So ito yung maliit na delta C. Ayan, ito yung delta C. Okay, so I hope nakita nyo yan, yung delta sign yun. Tapos kung delta C yun, anong tawag dito? Anong tawag dito? Diba yan ay deviation ng point C when a tangent line is drawn at A. PC/A. Okay? So, paano natin makakuha yung YC? So, palitan ko lang yung kulay ko. Okay, so YC. So, considering that triangle over there, I could say that So tangent of theta A, yung triangle, is opposite. Opposite is YC plus deviation of C slash A all over the adjacent of the triangle is 30 feet. Okay, so 30 feet. So 30 feet. Ayan. So from here, dito natin makukuha yung YC, yung deflection ng C. So yung theta A, wala tayong problema na solve na natin kanina, yung kulay orange, di ba? So ang sasolve na lang natin dito, yung deviation ng C slash A. Okay. So pag solve ng deviation ng C slash A, so that is, di ba? So yung T, C slash A can be solved as 1 over EI, so as per theorem number 2, of the area of the moment diagram, area ng moment diagram between these two points, so A and C, tapos taken distance tayo about dun sa first letter, which is C. So magmamoment tayo sa C. Okay, so para mas madali yung pagtitake ng moment nyo, kung saan kayo magtitake ng moment, dun kayo mag-reference axis sa pag-drawing ng moment diagram. Katulad kanina, diba, yung sinolve natin kanina, yung kulay orange, diba, deviation siya sa D slash A. Deviation sa D. Kaya doon tayo nag-reference sa D. Okay? So dito, this time, sa C tayo mag-reference para mapakita ko rin sa inyo kung ano yung itsura ng moment diagram by parts kapag ka sa C. Okay? Pagka sa C tayo mag-reference. Okay, so let me draw the moment diagram by parts when taken at C. Okay, so let's say ito yung moment diagram. So again, this is M over EI diagram. Okay? Sa C tayo magre-reference. Okay, so sa C. So ito yung point C. Dito ako magre-reference. Okay, reference sa C. Okay, so what are the moments effect ng lahat ng forces dun sa beam when we take moment at C? Okay, diba may reaction ako sa A na pataas? So from point A, pataas. Okay. So from point A, meron akong pataas, concentrated load. So tataas ako papunta dun sa C. So yan yung moment diagram by parts ko. So how much is that point? Diba ang reaction ko is, ilan ba yung reaction ko sa A? 40, diba? So kung 40 yun, 40 pataas times the moment arm is 30. So 40 times 30 is equal to 1,200. So meron akong 1,200 dito. Okay, so 1,200 ako dun sa point na to. Okay? Yan. So, that is the moment effect due to A at point C. Okay. So, what else? Hindi ba meron pa akong 60 kips? Okay. Yung 40 kips, wala nang moment effect siya kasi nasa point C na siya. Diba? So, yung 60 naman. Yung 60 kip, pababa siya. Diba? 60, ang moment arm ng 60 is 10. So, that is 600. Pababa. So, negative 600. Okay. So, negative 600. Okay, so paano yun? So, negative 600. So, from point B dito, pupunta ako dun sa point C. So, ito. Ayan. So, yan yung 600. Okay, so meron akong negative 600 dyan. Okay? So, extend ko lang yung line. Extend ko lang yung line. So, from there, extend ko lang yung line from here. Punta ron. Okay? Now, so yun yung negative 600. Ito yung point na to, negative 600. Guide link siya kay 60 na concentrated load pababa. Tapos meron pa akong tibang yung reaction sa D na 60 pataas. So nandito yun, tiba? 60 pataas, tapos papunta sa letter C. So 60 times the moment arm is 10. So 60 times 10 is 600. So, kung 600 yun, so from here, dito siya mapupunta. Ayan. Okay? And that is 600. 600. Ayan. So, di bali, what I have is tatlong triangles. Okay? So, tatlong triangles yung na-create ko kapag nag-reference ako sa C. Okay, so dito ako nag-reference sa C. Okay? Oops. Okay, so to solve for TC slash A. Okay, so that would be the 1 over EI of the area of the moment diagram between A and C. Okay, so basically, between A and C lang. So that means the area from here only. So that consists of the two triangles only. Okay, so that would be 1 over EI. Okay, so let's consider the first triangle. So ito yung first triangle dito, yung malaki. Okay, so that is 1/2. The base is 30. And the height is 120. Okay, then the centroid distance would be 30 over 3. Okay, so that is for the first pink na triangle. Now, how about yung pangalawang triangle, yung nasa baba naman? So, this one. So, the area is 1/2. Again, the base is 10. Then, the height is negative 600. And the distance of its centroid from C is 1/3 of 10. 1/3 of 10. So, basically, yan na yung PC/A. Okay? So, that's 15 times 120. Sorry, 12 rather. This should be 1,200. Okay. So, times 10. 10 times 600 times 10 over 3. So, we got 170,000. So, this is 170,000. This is kft cube over EI. Okay, so when we substitute it, when we substitute E tsaka I, so this will become again 170,000. 1, 2, 3. Again, this is kft cube. Okay, so i-multiply natin siya ng 12 over 1. 1 feet is 12 inches. So, i-cube natin sila parehas. Divided by E. E is 1/8. Okay, that's KSI, kip per square inch. Tapos, times natin ng I. 46,000. Okay, so this is in inch to the fourth. Okay, so maka-cancel lang yung kips. Tapos, yung inches cube. Tapos, ito inches square. So, ang lalabas sa calculator mo would be in inches na lang. So, times 12 cube. Okay, so divided by 1,800 divided by 46,000. So, what we got is 3.547A2. So, that is in inches. Okay, so let me store it sa A. Okay, so therefore, so substituting values here, okay, so what we'll get is, tangent of theta A. Theta A is 14.78 times 10 to the negative 3, okay, is equal to, okay, so YC, yan yung hinahanap natin, plus theta CA, which is 3.54782. This is in inches. So let us assume that yung sagot natin sa YC would be expressed in inches also. Divided by 30 feet. Kaya no, this is feet. So kailangan natin convert sa inches. So 12 inches is 1 foot. Okay? So from there, we could solve now for Y sub C or the deflection at point C. Okay, so we had a mistake here. Okay, so let me go back with this one. So tangent, yung 14.78 is actually expressed in radians. Since we are considering here the triangle, no? So for the triangle, so what we're going to, what we need to substitute here is the angle expressed in degrees. It should be in degrees. Okay, so instead of 14.78 to the negative 3 radians, which we will be using, we should be using the angle in terms of degrees. Kasi we are considering, diba, yung tangent is opposite over adjacent of the triangle. Okay, so the angle should be expressed in degrees. So 8.84, 691. degrees. Okay, so for that, we can solve now for y sub c. Okay, so solving for y sub c, that would give us 1.7738 inches. Okay, so, and of course, this is downward. Downward position. Okay, so that would be our final answer for this.